First of all, take out the maps we gave you all as you came in the door. The map is the big yellow sheet of paper. As you can see on the map, north is at the top, south at the bottom, etc. Which way is north? Well, look through that window on my left, your right. See the rising sun? That would have to be east. So north must be directly behind me. Now, we're at the campus main gate. The recreational facilities are on my right hand, and its opposite is the student center. No questions? Good. Pretty easy, right? Okay. Did everyone eat breakfast at the student food service this morning? Was the food good? Yes, yes, I am joking. I've eaten there too. So, after a meal like that, you must be eager to go to a doctor, right? Well, I have good news for you. The Student Health Center is located about half a kilometer straight north of here. Look on your maps. You see the street on the east side of this building, Ned Kelly Avenue? Just follow that about 500 meters and the health center will be on your left at the third cross street. Now, I know you all just got here, so you must be wondering how to tell your folks you've arrived safely, how much you miss the dog, and how you already need more money. If you don't have an iPhone, you probably are wondering where to find a computer. Well, I have good news. If you go straight out of its door and walk down the garden street, you'll see the internet unit on your left side, just next to the gym. The hours are posted on the door and the computers are free, but you must bring your student ID card with you. Like I tell everyone, if you need help with anything, you can probably find right here in the student center. Do you see the four buildings there between the student center and the library? Those are the dormitories. The men's dorms are the two on the south, the women's the two on the north. Okay, I'm sorry to have to tell you, but the university has been doing a lot of repairs and remodeling and it's not all done yet. So there may be some small problems with your dorm rooms. Maybe the window doesn't open. Maybe an air conditioner is missing or does not work. If there are any problems, you can go to the complaint office, which is right beside the teaching building between the Parker Street and the Cramer Street. Just tell them your problem and they should have it fixed by the time you graduate in 4 years. I'm joking, but please be patient. There are a lot of little things they need to take care of. Tired of the school food? No? Give it a week. Or maybe you just need a place to get coffee in the wee hours of the night during one of those marathon study sessions. Either way, you definitely have to check out the little cafe just past the women's dormitories. They've got free Wi-Fi, so a lot of students saddle up with coffee and a bagel for hours on end to get work done. First of all, take out the maps we gave you all as you came in the door. The map is the big yellow sheet of paper. As you can see on the map, north is at the top, south at the bottom, etc. Which way is north? Well, look through that window on my left, your right. See the rising sun? That would have to be east. So north must be directly behind me. Now, we're at the campus main gate. The recreational facilities are on my right hand and its opposite is the student center. No questions? Good. Pretty easy, right? Okay. Did everyone eat breakfast at the student food service this morning? Was the food good? Yes, yes, I am joking. I've eaten there too. So, after a meal like that, you must be eager to go to a doctor, right? Well, I have good news for you. The Student Health Center is located about half a kilometer straight north of here. Look on your maps. You see the street on the east side of this building, Ned Kelly Avenue? Just follow that about 500 meters and the health center will be on your left at the third cross street. Now, I know you all just got here, so you must be wondering how to tell your folks you've arrived safely, how much you miss the dog, and how you already need more money. If you don't have an iPhone, you probably are wondering where to find a computer. Well, I have good news. If you go straight out of its door and walk down the garden street, you'll see the internet unit on your left side, just next to the gym. The hours are posted on the door and the computers are free, but you must bring your student ID card with you. Like I tell everyone, if you need help with anything, you can probably find right here in the student center. Do you see the four buildings there between the student center and the library? Those are the dormitories. The men's dorms are the two on the south, the women's the two on the north. Okay, I'm sorry to have to tell you, but the university has been doing a lot of repairs and remodeling and it's not all done yet. So there may be some small problems with your dorm rooms. Maybe the window doesn't open. Maybe an air conditioner is missing or does not work. If there are any problems, you can go to the complaint office, which is right beside the teaching building between the Parker Street and the Cramer Street. Just tell them your problem and they should have it fixed by the time you graduate in 4 years. I'm joking, but please be patient. There are a lot of little things they need to take care of. Tired of the school food? No? Give it a week. Or maybe you just need a place to get coffee in the wee hours of the night during one of those marathon study sessions. Either way, you definitely have to check out the little cafe just past the women's dormitories. They've got free Wi-Fi, so a lot of students saddle up with coffee and a bagel for hours on end to get work done.